الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقال جل وعلا: يسألك الناس عن الساعة قل إنما علمها عند الله. فقال جل وعلا في مقام آخر: يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها. My respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. July 1999, the fall French prophet of the 16th century was on the lips of everybody, Muslim, non-Muslim alike. And if you remember, he made the media big time. The TV, the newspapers, the magazine, the radio. Everybody around the globe was talking about one person, Nostradamus, and his prediction that the world was going to end. Now, in spite of the majority of his predictions that he made in the past proved to be wrong, in spite of this, many people really began to believe that the world was really going to end the day he predicted. To the extent that some kuffar left their home looking for a safe haven, looking for a refuge, looking for a place which will save them from this disaster. In this very city, Leeds, what did we see? We saw the New Age travelers in the middle of your city center, sitting in a neat round circle with their heads down and all their luggage waiting for the world to end. It was sad to hear that this prediction of Nostradamus proved strong enough that it created doubt and rocked the iman of some Muslims with regards to when the world will end. And if you remember, there was thunder on that night, and there was lightning in many places, and this really increased fear in those weak people that really believed that the world was going to end. But did the world end? The world did not end. And now we have the millennium around the corner. We have the millennium around the corner, and many kuffar have begun to believe that the millennium will bring with it the end of the world. Because some of the kuffar believe that on the turn of the millennium, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend from the heavens. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend from the heavens And there will be a great war. And thus the world will end. Not only have they begun to believe this, many Christians from the States, the United States of America, have begun to move to Palestine, to Bayt al-Maqdis, to the Mount of Olives, as they believe this is where Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is going to descend. So they are moving to Palestine because they want to witness this event. They want to see Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam come down from the heavens. And come the millennium, the Muslims yet again will be tested. And yet again the Muslims will ask one another, is the world really going to end? What does Islam say about the ending of the world? Listen very carefully to what the Quran says. The Quran says, يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they ask you regarding the hour. Qiyamah, when will Qiyamah come? Tell them, its knowledge is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet again the Quran says, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا فِيمَا أَنْتَ مِنْ ذِكْرَاهَا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ مُنْتَهَاهَا. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they ask you regarding the hour when it will occur. Allah says, tell them that it is not the business of any prophet to tell its exact time. Why? Because no prophet knows when Qiyamah will take place. Its knowledge is only with the same being who created this world. The hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala and Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, a man came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أخبرني عن الإيمان. Tell me, what is Iman? He said, Allah alayhi wa sallam replied, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خير وشره والبعث بعد الموت. Believe in Allah. Believe in His angels. Believe in His books, His messengers. Believe in faith, good and bad. And believe in life after death. This is Iman. The stranger posed another question to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, tell me, what is Islam? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا. Testify there is no God worthy of worship and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Offer your prayers and give your zakat. Fast in the month of Ramadan and perform Hajj if you have the means. This is Islam. The third question he posed to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me, mal ihsan? What is ihsan? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, كَأَنْ تَعْبُدَ اللَّهِ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَى فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَى فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى. That worship Allah with such concentration as if you can see Allah. And if you cannot get to this stage, then worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowing that the Almighty is watching every action. This is ihsan. Yes, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now tell me, مَتَ السَّاعَةُ. When is the hour? When will Qiyamah take place? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the stranger, مَا الْمَسْئُولُ أَنْهَا بِأَعْلَمْ مِنَ السَّائِرِ. That the one questioned has no more knowledge about Qiyamah than the one that has questioned. Meaning the questioner and know the one that has questioned knows anything about Qiyamah when it will take place. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, I will inform you of its time. إِذَا وَلَدَتِ الْأَمَةُ رَبَّهَا. When a slave girl gives birth to her master, and when poor shepherds begin to construct lofty big buildings, then six, the hour is close. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there are five things and nobody has the knowledge of which besides the Almighty Himself. But in the very same gathering, Can we start with the verse of the Quran? إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ إِلْمُ السَّعْرِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. The first